Hello, welcome to episode 7 in the Power On series. In this episode, we'll be looking at the EEPROM Verifier. You can check out last episode where we looked at the short locator. So, Manip, what can you tell me about the EEPROM Verifier?
Sure, so the EEPROM Verifier is one of the instruments that's available with the BFL, the Board Fault Locator. So, in the previous episode, we were focused on the ATM, the Advanced Test Module. In this episode, we're looking at the BFL, but both modules work in a similar way. They're both used to test digital ICs and PCBs as well. So, before we have a look at the EEPROM Verifier in detail, what we have here is a digital IC tester, and the reason why we have this open is because we're going to test to see if we have any incoming signals into our EEPROM, so then we can disable that before we move on into the EEPROM Verify test itself.
Right, just like we did on the advanced IC identifier, which you can also watch.
Exactly, which makes use of the BDO cable as well.
Yeah.
So within the digital IC tester, we have our EEPROM, which is a CMOS EEPROM. And we're doing a connection and voltage test. Again, we're going to check all the signals that are coming in. We're going to check the voltages to make sure our device is stable before moving on into the EEPROM Verifier test. So all we need to do is simply click start and wait for the results. Okay, there we are. So simple as that. So we can also test the functionality of the device. However, that will take a long time. But for this demonstration, we're only looking at the connection and voltage test. And as we can see, the system has already very quickly identified all our open circuits, our VCC, our ground, our highs and lows, and we can also see all the voltages as well. And we don't have any incoming signals disrupting our EEPROM. So we have our BDO cable, and again, just a reminder that this is a power on test, so we obviously need to power up our PCB.
I think one thing we didn't mention in the advanced IC identifier as well is that you can find these sort of these signals and where they're coming from looking at the schematics. And they've also got a RevEng system which actually generates the schematics for you. And I think the good thing about the EEPROM Verifier as well is, just like our JTAG Master, is that you can use it to actually test those EEPROM devices and JTAG devices to have that clarity of thought, knowing that that's actually not the problem, not the faulty component, and that it could be the devices around it. You can see our JTAG episode in the future, so stay tuned for that.
Exactly. So there's a common myth amongst many technicians, many engineers, that they think the EEPROM and JTAG enabled devices are at fault initially. But what we find is that those devices themselves are fine. It's mainly the components surrounding that device, for example, resistors, diodes, relays, things like that, that are at fault.
Right, okay.
So we can simply do the EEPROM Verifier test, check that off the list, and you know, once we're happy that the device is working, we can move on into the other tests.
Okay, fantastic.
Okay, so now that we're happy with our device, that is passing, that is stabilized, everything's fine, we can then move on into the EEPROM Verifier itself. Okay, so this is the EEPROM Verifier, and what we can see is it looks fairly simple, and we have the read, verify, open, save option. So what we can do is we can read the contents of the EEPROM we have in front of us. We can then save that data and then use that saved data, obviously from a good working board, to then verify against another PCB or another EEPROM that we may see in the future. And because we're doing it in circuit, we obviously need to check all our incoming signals into our EEPROM itself. Hence why we use the BDO cable. But if we are testing out of circuit with the out of circuit adapter, we don't need any of that. We simply connect the IC by itself into the out of circuit adapter. And obviously the out of circuit adapter is connected directly to the BFL itself. Simply click on and start the test.
Right, so that's an easy way of isolating that IC and not getting any interference.
So you have options of doing it either in or out of circuit, so the choice is yours. So simply open up the previously stored information by simply clicking on it like so. And then once this data opens and is available within the instrument, we can then use that to verify against the EEPROM you have.
So yeah, I think EEPROMs are on most legacy PCBs now. So this instrument's really come into its prime because EEPROM's been around for 10, 20, 30 years. They tend to lose their memory at the end of their life cycle. So it's good now to just hop on that clip and just test if those EEPROMs have retained any of their memory.
Exactly. We can also use it for predictive and corrective maintenance, obviously.
Right.
Okay, as you can see, our save data has now opened. So we can see all the data, all the checksum. Before we saw FFF, which was basically blank.
Yep.
There's no data there, but now we see all the information. And this is the information from our previously stored data. So from our previously tested good working board.
Okay, fantastic.
So all we need to do now is simply click verify. And what that does is it compares the previously stored information against our EEPROM, our PCB that we have in front of us. Brilliant. So all we need to do is click on verify. another system is going through the verification process, matching all the data, matching the lines, making sure that our EEPROM is working as it should. So now, as you can see, our verification has finished. We can see that it says complete, and this is an indication that our device is fine.
Fantastic, and you can implement that in your test flow as well, so when you get that pass, you can move on. Right, fantastic, thank you, Muneeb. So that was our episode on the EEPROM verifier. Stay tuned for next week, where we'll be touching on the merits of both the BFL and the ATM.